The Unspoken Truth About Pests on Ag Day, brought to you by AgriSure Traits. Combine the power of AgriSure Duracade plus AgriSure Viptera trait stacks to control 16 yield-damaging above and below ground pests.
It's that time of year when nature can really dial up the pest pressure. In part two of a new series called The Unspoken Truth About Pests, we're looking at some of the new and emerging challenges farmers are facing this growing season.
Scouting for pests is part of the job for agronomist Mark Eat.
The feeding can often be mistaken for flea beetle feeding in corn.
This year, it isn't insects giving farmers fits, it's slugs.
Slugs are actually not an insect. They're a gastropod, so they are a shell-less snail. They do most of their damage in the early part of the growing season.
No-till or minimum-till fields with plenty of cover, combined with cool spring weather, set up parts of northern Indiana for major slug damage.
I have seen a field not too far from where we're standing right now that was replanted four times.
One of those insects that we're seeing more of, and I don't really know the reason why, is wireworm. We're dealing with more wireworm every year.
Farm Journal agronomist Ken Ferry says the issue is also a problem in fields farmers were forced to replant.
And the populations seem to be building, or we find more fields with wireworm issues.
Ferry says the reason remains a mystery, but up-and-coming pest pressure is something Ferry continues to watch.
The other insect that we do see more of each year in Illinois is the northern rootworm beetle. It used to be more of an Iowa, Wisconsin bug, and it seems to be moving in, especially in the northern parts of the state. And we'll have to be dealing with that as those pressures build.
As certain pest pressures build, Farm Journal agronomist Missy Bauer says it's often geography-based.
I think it depends really where you're at. I mean, certainly like here in Michigan, we're dealing with western bean cutworm way more than we used to. You know, 10 years ago, we didn't hardly have to deal with it all. Now it's something an every year thing we're paying attention to.
There's another emerging issue happening in fields that tend to be sandier.
Asiatic garden beetle is another new emerging pest for us here in Michigan. Likes the sandier soils and really can cause problems in young corn and emerging corn, feeding on corn roots and give you a lot of unevenness out there in the fields.
From soil type to seed type, there are other factors fueling insect populations and problems.
Many of the corn earworm in the South have become resistant to the types of BT that are used to manage them. So not only are we getting influxes of corn earworm, we're getting influxes of BT-resistant corn earworm.
But as traits continue to evolve to help farmers combat pests, Bauer says there are insects that farmers no longer battle every year.
I'd say one pest we used to deal with, especially when I first started my career, European corn borer. And I wouldn't say that we never have it. Some people have conventional corn, and if you have conventional corn, you still need to be out there and scouting it. But where so much corn is traded now, that seems to be one thing we just don't have to deal with very often.
If the pressure is high enough where they're actually causing economic damage, you're going to be able to find them.
Even as agronomists like Eads continue to battle pests, both known and unknown each year.